say, you know, I actually am not seeking to disrupt externally. I think it goes back more to what George was saying, that there's behind the kitchen situation. I mean, when I first graduated from Duke, I went to training at a cafe in downtown LA, and I had the chef's hat on, and it's very interesting, like, learning about how to make huge vats of bread pudding and what it does to make it successfully. It's a big deal, or how you order for a freezer to do all that. We look at it the same way. Our disruption happens internally. We're not there necessarily to go viral and have the next greatest, biggest thing and then have it peter out. We want consistent community built over time. We're a little bit different that way. I'm a marathon runner, so I'm like, you don't stop, it's step, step, step. I'm not sitting there sprinting and then later on the sidewalk, right? So I'm kind of that person that's like, boom, boom, boom. We're not going away, we're going, we're going, we're going. I'm expecting disruption, innovative thinking from my team internally. I don't necessarily go out and promote that we're marketing nonprofits and that's our disruption, but it is internal disruption because you're forcing yourself to think differently than what your original mission was. So I think of disruption as not so much of a PR external thing, at least for us. For me, it's like, we need to push ourselves to think differently. How can we fundraise differently? How can we help our nonprofits differently? Sometimes we might not be able to track results on the site, but we are doing results offline. That's disruptive to us, to go, we're not going to get everything reported on the site. But are we doing good? Is it happening and documented? Yes. So I'm different. I may be different. I see Eric, he was a major, like, public disruptor in a great way. I just think there's two different philosophies on that disruption.